In this video, I'm going to reveal to you my personal WWDC wishlist. But in order to do that, I need your help. So before the end of the intro, answer this question in the comments below. What is your number one wish from WWDC 2020? Let's do this. No, I really mean it. Go down in the comments and state what do you wish WWDC 2020 should bring us. And while you do that, let me talk about Beyond Code. This is something that I've been working for months now, and I have been asked to do so for, I don't know, a year or so. People just came up to me and said, okay, you have this following on the YouTube channel, but it's just kind of like me talking to you guys. We want to talk to each other. We want to have a community. So that's what I did. I have created the community for not just iOS developers. It's at rebeloper.com/community. It's called Beyond Code, where we have mentorships, accountability, and insider access. Let me just show you what this is going to include. It includes 4 Zoom groom coaching calls each month with special guests and amazing topics. Yes, we are going to have 1 group coaching call with me, 1 hour per week. And of course, you can take a look at the content library because we are going to record all of that. So no worries if you skipped any of those Zoom calls, you can take a look at them later on. Also, there's exclusive content. You can also meet your peers. One of my favorite topics, one of my favorite things inside the community, and also some extras. Let me just show you how it is inside currently our community. We have already some founding members, and as of today, I'm opening the doors to more founding members, and this will be closed after WWDC ends. So only this week. Make sure you go at rebeloper.com/community and sign up. Now, this is how it looks like. We have introductions, ask questions, announcements, and the general. Now, the most important part, what many people do like, is actually the events. And as you can see, we already had created our first founder launch party, and tomorrow we are going to have our next community event, and it will be about APIs. So yeah, go ahead and sign up so you get to know that event, you get to participate on that event live. And as you can see, we have a lot of options that we can have direct messages with our users. Also, you can ask me, just go ahead and ask a question. We will try to ask you answer you as soon as possible. Also, the community is really keen on answering your questions, and hopefully you will be a part of that community. You will also contribute for others. Okay, that's at rebeloper.com/community. Now let's get back to my wish list of WWDC 2020. So here are 5 things that I wish WWDC will give us in SwiftUI. Now the first one is better alerts. You know, you can create alerts, and with SwiftUI 2, this is the option that you can have buttons inside those alerts, but still there are view modifiers. And what I would really like to have is an imperative way of constructing and presenting alerts in SwiftUI. And of course, where are the text fields? We don't have text fields in SwiftUI, so we have to dig down in UIKit to have a text field in those alerts. Really, really cumbersome to use. So what I would like to have number one priority in SwiftUI 4 is a better alert. Now, second what I would like to see is decoupled navigation. Now, decoupled navigation means that you are not coupling your navigation, your destination view, to the current view that you are navigating from. Now, in UIKit and also in SwiftUI, this is not possible. You already know that you have this navigation link view, and then you have your sheet and full screen cover view modifier, which are kind of confusing. Why are there 2 types of navigations? But anyway, we are always coupling the views, the destination, to our current view. So I would like to see something in SwiftUI 4 that has a decoupled navigation. Of course, I already have my own product for that, you know, navigation stack, but that's kind of what I have created. I would like to see this incorporated in SwiftUI 4. Now, number 3 is toasts. You know, we have the alerts, but what about toasts? What about a progress HUD? What about a heads-up display? telling people what is going on, like fetching data from the server or something like that. We don't have natively that inside SwiftUI. Of course, we can construct that as usual. We can create our very own toasts or progress huts inside our SwiftUI apps. But again, that is taking up time. It's not the Apple way of doing this. Like, it is the Apple way of doing this, but it's not provided by the SwiftUI framework. So I would really like to see a toast in SwiftUI 4. Number 4 is image picker view. Now, you already know that we can add the image picker view inside our SwiftUI app with the UI view controller representable that will bring up a UI kit element. Now, that is cumbersome. I would like to see that incorporated natively inside SwiftUI 4, so we don't have to have these UI view controller representables all the time. Okay, and finally, we have number 5, better text editor. Now, text editor has been around for a while, but it is really having not that many functionalities to say the least. For example, background color, or selecting, copy and pasting, or all of those tiny little stuff that the UI text view did have, but UI text editor doesn't, the SwiftUI's text editor doesn't have. So I would like to have a better text editor in SwiftUI 4. Now, those were the 5 on my wish list of WWDC 2020. And if you do want to join my community, go ahead and check it out. It's at rebeloper.com/community. It is going to be open only during WWDC 2020. So if you do want to become a founder, go ahead and check it out. Again, it's at rebeloper.com/community. And if you did like this video, you are most probably curious of how you want to make some money on the App Store. So go ahead and check out this video right over here next.